Let's talk about whether or not 2021 will be as strong as 2020.
Absolutely. Good morning, Dom. Thank you for having me. Yeah, absolutely. You know, we have strong fundamentals going into COVID, and you have things like the average age of the home, nearly 40 years old. You know, they need repair and replacement. Mortgage rates remain low, which drive housing demand, and it also drives kitchen and bath remodeling. So we expect a lot of growth, continued growth in 2021.
All right. So what's driving that growth? We know that there's been a huge influx of people to suburban communities from urban centers because of the virus pandemic. A lot of people choosing to opt for, you know, any kind of life outside of a densely populated area. Is it new home sales? Is it people who are still in their homes looking to remodel? What's the biggest driver of that spend in home remodeling?
Yeah, it's a lot of the people remaining in their home and, you know, working in their home, schooling in their home. They have these spaces that they've been looking at for a while, but they were spending a lot of time taking the kids all over the place and commuting and things like that. They didn't have some of the discretionary funds that they're saving by not going on vacation. So these rooms in the home where, you know, you spend a lot of time, you want to make them better. And so I think people just continue to invest in their sanctuary, whether that's the bathroom and the kitchen, especially those two areas where we spend the most time.
You know, I remember, you know, there have been a couple times I've been involved with real estate transactions, and people would always tell me, sometimes realtors would say that kitchens and bathrooms are the places that you want to spend because it's the place that you will find the biggest return on your investment, or at least a payoff of what you've spent. What exactly is the driving force behind why kitchens and baths are as important to homeowners as the way that they are right now?
You know, it's the focal point of the home. It's also where you spend most of the time. Historically, you spent the most time in the kitchen, but now even more than ever. So these are the places where you're cooking your food, you're spending the time with the family, kids are hooked up, they're doing their schoolwork. This is where you want to make the best place in your home. And now that you're forced to stay in your home, you know, more than, you know, usual during COVID, why not make it better if you have the funds? So, I mean, we're very happy that, you know, and also, you know, on the bathroom side, people need a space to escape. I mean, clearly in this environment more than ever. So those two rooms are where you spend most of the time. You want to make them better for your family. I mean, 16% growth we project in 2021 and up to $160 billion in sales. So this is a place where it's going to continue to grow. And we encourage homeowners to take a strong look at this. Now, also contractors are going to be maybe probably allowed in the home more frequently in 2021. So if you look at 2020, where some people still did projects, they might have been a bit reluctant to have contractors in the home. But with all the positive signs around the vaccines and things coming, we expect homeowners to be even more confident to have contractors in their homes doing projects in 21.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.